Namaste, everybody. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you all to this evening's program by Prakriti Dance. Prakriti Dance brings to you Amba Shikhandi, a journey of courage. Inspired by the Mahabharata, Amba Shikhandi, a journey of courage, narrates the story of Amba, who goes to any lengths possible to find justice. Taken away from her true love by Bhishma, she finds herself unable to marry and is now alone, ostracized by the society. Instead of accepting her fate, she seeks divine intervention to find her own justice. Like Amba, may we all have the courage to follow our own journeys and find our true destinies. May the roaring flame of Amba Shikhandi's spirit blaze a path for us all. The dancers of this evening are Kashi Aisola, Ramya Kapadia, Madhavi Reddy, Vanita Todkar, and Madhavi Venkatesh. The musicians of this evening are, on vocal, we have Lavanya Kailash, Nattuvangam, Sridevi Jagannath, Mridangam, Vishrut Sudhakar, and violin, Shruti Sarathi. Sarvebhi Modantam. Dhanyavadaha.
We are our deepest desire. Our desire becomes our will. Our will guides our deeds. Our deeds carve our destiny. Just as the lotus bud blossoms, untainted in a murky pond, thrashing in turbulent waters, the spirit is forever pure, glimmering, thriving, soaring through this mundane existence. Just as the floral petals unfold, pink and pristine, the spirit shines within, brighter, more beautiful, and forever resilient, despite adversity. Amba Shikhandi.
Ma pada ni sa,
Do we live in good or bad, right or wrong? Is it only his world and not hers? In a world where choice was unconditional, the rules were bent, there once lived three princesses of Kashi: Amba, Ambika, and Ambalika. They were soon to be wed by the custom of Swayamvara, where royal suitors competed for their hands in marriage. Being of royalty, the three maidens dutifully lived their lives as princesses, except Amba. With a sharp intellect and a fiery passion for life, Amba was always different. She was royalty by day, yet held a secret by night. One day, Amba stole a moment to herself. Curious about Amba's privacy, her sisters playfully pestered her to know who was this mysterious lover after all. Amba revealed her secret lover was King Shalva. She slipped into dreams of her time with Shalva, when suddenly the sounds of the wedding procession startled her, bringing her back to reality. Takajam, jam, tari kitta takundari kitta takka takajam, tari takajam, jam,
Thank you.
The suitors of the Swayamvara were swiftly defeated by the leader of the Kuru dynasty, Bhishma. Utilizing his immortal strength, Bhishma annihilated the suitors. He whisked away Amba and her sisters in an act of valor to marry his brother Vichitravirya. Boastfully he proclaimed, "O maidens of Kashi, your beauty and virtue are of the highest order for my brother Vichitravirya. Was their virtue his to take unfairly and give away? Had Amba not already promised her heart to another?" Tum taka 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 tum 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 taka tum taka tum taka tum taka tum tarikidaga tum tarikidaga taka tarikidaga tum taka tum taka tum taka tum taka tum tarikidaga tum tarikidaga taka tarikidaga tum taka 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 tarikidaga tum taka 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 tarikidaga tum tarikidaga tum tarikidaga taka tarikidaga tum tarikidaga tum tarikidaga taka tarikidaga tum tarikidaga tum tarikidaga taka tarikidaga taka tum 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 taka taka tum 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 taka.
Kashipate Kalya, he Ambe Ambike Ambalike, Pama Parisani Sada Padadani Nisa Sasani Risapa, Pama Parisani Sada Padadani Nisa Sasani Risapa. Thank you.
sullen and without choice, the three sisters dressed themselves in fine silks and jewels to wed Vichitravirya. Huh, what an irony that Amba only thought of Shalva, her true love, and how she would never see him again on her wedding day. When Bhishma arrived to escort the princesses to the wedding, Amba courageously burst out, "My heart lies with another, O Bhishma. I have promised myself to him. You are known as the master of all virtues. Do the right thing and let me go to him." Upon hearing this, Bhishma showed mercy on Amba for her honesty and persuasive reasoning and allowed her to go. And so Amba went to reunite with Shalva. Upon arriving at Shalva's palace, Amba excitedly announced that she had come to reunite with him. Shalva, having been defeated and ridiculed at the Swayamvara was hurt and filled with anger. He harshly rejected Amba, alluding that she had become tainted and claimed by another. He denied the relationship, callously shunning her away. "Go wherever you please." These words echoed in Amba's mind, stripping her like a barren stem, petal by petal. Where would she go? What would she do? Who would accept her? Dejected and alone, Amba lamented, "I have been robbed of all that is dear to me. Who is to blame for my plight? Shame on Bhishma for abducting us. Shame on my father who pawned us away. Shame on me for not acting sooner. Shame on the creator who cursed me with this fate. The true cause of my misery is none other than Bhishma. I will avenge myself and destroy him. But how? I'm only a woman. How dare I challenge him?" Broken, Amba writhed in pain, blaming herself, doubting her ability. An internal battle ensued, mutilating her inner spirit, killing her confidence to succeed and her resilient ways. Amba cast herself into a void, no longer feeling worthy of existence. Judgment, disdain, ridicule, all passed Amba's way, yet her spirit refused to be silenced. It began to emerge, relentless, dispelling her self-hatred and challenging opinions and opposition. She grew stronger from within, making her presence felt. Reclaiming herself anew, Amba became the stone that rippled the pond of society.
Shalvam vachanam mama sa sa da da pa ma ga ri ga ga ni ni da da ni ni mama ni ni da pa ma ga sa sa ga ga sa sa mama sa sa da da pa ma ga ri ga ga ni ni da da ni ni mama ni ni da pa ma ga sa sa ga ga sa sa ma sa sa da da pa ma ga ri ga ga ni ni da da ni ni mama ni ni da pa ma ga sa sa ga ga sa sa mama sa sa da da pa ma ga ri ga ga ni ni da da ni ni mama ni ni da pa ma ga sa sa ga ga sa sa mama sa sa da da pa ma ga ri ga ga ni ni da da ni ni mama ni ni da pa ma ga sa sa ga ga sa sa mama sa sa da da pa ma ga ri ga ga ni ni da da ni ni mama ni ni da pa ma ga sa ga sa ma sa da
After a long inner journey of penance, Amba found herself. She broke her meditative state to cleanse herself in the seemingly sacred river Ganga. As she stepped into the river, Amba felt the water rising and taking shape in an unceremonious manner. Questioning the purpose of her penance, Ganga Devi appeared, wishing to dissuade Amba from pursuing the destruction of her son, the great Bhishma. Telling her that she was seeking the impossible, Ganga Devi advised Amba to relinquish her quest. Even in pilgrimage, Amba was denied. Unwavering and determined, Amba spoke of her vow. In an effort to hinder Amba's quest, Ganga Devi cursed her to shed half her body and become a dry, crooked river filled with crocodiles, instilling fear in all life. Amba did not succumb to Ganga's curse. Instead, she faced the crocodiles of life head on and continued her journey to find justice.
कामो न वद्यांगी बले यदि भीष्म विनाशाय कुटिला नदी भविष्यसि कुटिला नदी भविष्यसि कुटिला नदी भविष्यसि भीमग्राहवती गोरह सर्वभूत भयंकरी
Thank you.
without support from any other creatures or forces, Amba steadfastly worshipped Lord Shiva. For he was the embodiment of destructive energy. Hearing her sincere beckoning, Shiva appeared to Amba. He granted her a boon to destroy Bhishma in her next birth. Elated and eager to enter her next life, Amba gathered wood and built a funeral pyre. She jumped into the pyre on the banks of the Yamuna River, saying, "For the destruction of Bhishmasena." Thus, freeing her spirit, she ended her life as Amba.
Gama gama da pa ma gari ni sa 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 ga 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 gama da pa ma gari sa.
Amba was reborn in her next life as Shikhandini to King Drupada of Panchala. Lord Shiva instructed Drupada not to raise Shikhandini as an ordinary princess, but rather as a male child. Drupada was told to teach her the art of warfare, as her destiny was to defeat the great Bhishma. As Shikhandini and her sister Draupadi grew up, Shikhandini was tormented by flashbacks of her previous life as Amba. Unable to ignore these visions, she finally accepted her past. Enveloped in memories of her previous life, Shikhandini embarked on her final journey seeking justice. She's transformed into male Shikhandi and accepted her past identities as one with herself. Upon hearing Krishna's divine call, Amba Shikhandi rode into battle, launching the arrow that ended the Kurukshetra war.
Thank you. Tajam, 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 tajam.
That which seems to be poison can be transformed into nectar by purity and truth. Those who face adversity will always triumph as the human spirit is resilient. after many births to fulfill our destinies and final internal happiness, we are illuminated within and attain true freedom. Like Amba, may we embrace all aspects of ourselves as one collective whole.
Nadre dim, dom pre dim, nadre.
They have taken us through an emotional journey from the depths of the despair that Amba felt to the ultimate accomplishment through her ekagrata and tapas. It's like Goddess Saraswati has taken form in 9 different ways, and we couldn't be prouder too. The very concept of showing how somebody could redeem herself from the depths of despair, it's such a complicated concept, and each one of us was rooting for Amba while she was picking up herself, and we wanted to go and pull her up and give her the courage of journey. And I was so emotional. On this auspicious day, they have expanded our consciousness. I think they sowed the seeds that we all take back. It is up to us, are we taking seeds of compassion or determination or tapas or ekagrata? Whatever we want to take, they certainly touched our lives and changed our lives forever. We are very grateful. And Sanskrit Bharati is eternally grateful for the community support we receive from each and every one of you. Now please give a big hand to yourselves for supporting us. I now request Ravi Mahodaya to honor the artists. Kasi Aishola, co-director of Prakriti Dance Choreography. Madhvi Venkatesh, co-director of Prakriti Dance. Madhvi. Ramya Kapadia, music composition. Madhavi Reddy, Vanita Torkar, and now we have our musicians team, another band of Saraswati's, vocal and Tibetan bowl, Lavanya Kailash, Natuvangam Sridevi Jagannath. Isn't it such a pleasure to watch young artists on the violin and on the mridangam? Visrut and Srut. Visrut Sudhakar and Shruti Sarathi. Give them all a big hand. And we want to thank Ryan from the Cary Arts Center and Seema Vishwanath for the lighting. And for sound, we would like to thank Sean from the Cary Arts Center. Videography and photography, we have Balu Narayanan and Arun Kumar. Kaylin and Sarah Preston, Jamie, Connie, and the staff of the Cary Arts Center for facilitating this entire event. And Brandon and Brendan for audio and headsets.